Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to enroll a 5800SS1 wireless shock sensor. While we have this listed under our glass break detectors, and it does in fact protect against broken glass, this is very different than a glass break detector. The 5853 was our wireless glass break detector, and we talked about how that device uses an audio microphone to hear the frequency of broken glass and pick up an alarm that way. With the shock sensor, what it's actually detecting is vibrations. So this device mounts directly to a window pane. You typically would mount it, let's say this is our window pane, you would mount it an inch from the side and the bottom in the corner, and then if someone's banging on the glass to break it, you're detecting the alarm even before the glass breaks, just on the vibration of someone trying to enter the property. While this has its applications, there are certainly some things to keep in mind. If this is on a window and you're in an area where you get a lot of thunder, and thunder is enough to rattle your windows, the rattling windows could cause false alarms, so be careful about that. Also, you do need this for each pane of the window. So it can get expensive if you have many panes in your window. So keep that in mind as well. However, again, there are applications where this is a great device, and we're gonna show you how to enroll it or program it to your Lynx Touch L5200 system. If we pop the cover off the device, on the inside, we have a couple things going on. First, we have our serial number displayed here and here. We have our CR2, which is a battery we've yet to see before, but it's the battery that we use with this device. It's a lithium battery. It's got a little plastic tab which keeps the contact from being active in the shipping mode or in delivery to the customer. And basically, we have a tamper switch as well, which when the cover is on, is held down, and therefore you would know if the cover was popped. So, this battery is installed. Circuitry is now powered up, and we're ready to enroll our 5800SS1 shock sensor. We go to Security, More, and Tools, and we enter our installer code. 4112 allows us to choose Program, and then from there we have Zones, and we hit the down arrow until we get to our next available open zone. Each wireless device gets enrolled to a separate zone, and so we want the next available zone, zone 26, and we click Edit. So now that we're in our zone 26 programming page, we have to click into our serial number box to enroll the sensor serial number. And we can do it two ways. One is to type in the serial number, but as we've described in a lot of our other videos, by activating the device, it auto-enrolls the sensor, which does two things. It makes sure that the serial number gets programmed in properly, and beyond that, it also verifies that the sensor's working to our expectations. So because this is picking up shock or vibrations, the way to activate this device is to tap lightly on the back. We hear the double tap gave us a beep. Tap again. Sometimes the faults, we gotta try a couple more times. There we go, we get the double beep. The enroll, the serial number is enrolled, 0165839. We get the loop number 1, and then we do one final tap. Nope, even me shaking it was enough to get that final activation in there. So, we've got our serial number and our loop number, and we're ready to select the rest of what we want. So, you have some available response type. There's nothing that says shock, so in this case we want glass break. Even though it's not technically a glass break sensor, it's more of a shock sensor, it is also a glass break. We're gonna leave it at that. Response type is perimeter. That means it will be an instant alarm if it's ever activated, which is of course what we would want. If the system is armed and someone's banging on our window, we wanna know right away. And then finally, we're gonna name where we're gonna put this sensor. In this case, we're gonna put it in the dining room. So we do D for dining. That takes us to the DA words. If we hit the I, dining. We get dining.
Dining room.
And if we hit that, we get dining room. And to give it the further clarification that it's a shock sensor.
Say shed, shock.
Dining room, shock, glass break. Then we have the best description of what this device is. Alarm report means that when this device is activated, it will send the alarm to the central station. That is what we want. That is a toggle option, so if for any reason we wanted it to sound the full alarm at the panel but not send through to the central, you could select no, but in most cases you want that on if you're monitored. Chime, that would indicate if someone was banging on your door or your window in the disarm state, it would actually beep, beep, beep. Most cases with this device, you don't want a chime. And then supervision means that the panel will look for this device and this serial number every 12 hours. If the sensor is never isn't seen at that 12-hour period, then it would throw up a supervision trouble, and you would know that you have an issue to address with your zone 26 sensor. Perhaps it's too far away from the panel, or perhaps there's interference between the panel and the device. Anything that would prevent this sensor from talking to the system would be addressed by having it supervised. So we always recommend that you have your protection zone set to supervised. If we save our selection and close up our sensor cover, now we're ready to test it. We exit to the home screen, and now what we're going to do, normally again, you mount this on your window, and there's actually in the instruction guide a detailed description of how you would tap with the back side of a screwdriver in the opposite corner of the window. So you would mount here, tap here, and that would indicate the sensor works. For our purposes, to verify it's working, we're just going to do the double tap on the back, and we get our fault, not ready to arm. You can very briefly see that it shows the zone in question. It's restoring too fast to even see it, but if we continue to fault it, you can see that it's showing the fault on the 26, which is our dining room window. So now we know we have properly enrolled our 5800SS1 wireless shock sensor to our Lynx Touch L5200 panel. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We invite you to subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions on this 5800SS1 shock sensor or your Honeywell wireless security system, please email us support@alarmgrid.com.